Hi Leo, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity in your personal lives and in your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Leo's, it's quite a potent month. We have Sun, your ruling planet, and Venus that is there in your house of groups of activity and friends and people with whom you share a similar goal. And on the 4th, we have a new moon there as well. Now, this is a time where a lot of focus is there, especially with Venus being over there in this part of your chart, that you may actually fall in love with an old friend. It can be that someone you've known for a long time, or you could have sort of dated on and off and is a friend. You know, it's the person is definitely not an acquaintance. It's not someone that you meet now and then. You share a lot of common interests, a lot of passions. You're really fond of each other. There's been always, forever, this great chemistry. And you'll find that all of a sudden you're seeing this person very differently. And there's a sense of just feeling very good about your future. And I think even finding pleasure in a lot of things that are unusual and unconventional. It's a time where a lot of you are going to be embracing individuality more openly. It's a time wherein that you're not just making people conform or looking at people in a certain typecast, but there's also a time you are going to be sort of letting people off the hook and saying, you know, live and let live, and that's the best way. You're going to be with a new moon, and again in this house of your groups of friends and like-minded people. It's a time where, you know, you'll find that if certain relationships with a group of friends have just sort of gone off, you'll be able to be more honest, transparent with them and tell them exactly, you know, what's really been going on. And broadening your network of your friends and business associates during this time, it's really beneficial for you. We have Mercury as well that is coming and joining this part of your chart, and it's just going to be making you really chatty, conversations about traveling together. Maybe there's a long road trip that is being or that's there on the cards. For some of you, it can also be that you're planning maybe to start a company, or maybe start a project with not just a friend. It could be a group of friends who are just getting together and putting up a small company, an outfit, and you could be very keen to see that through as well. On the 18th, we have Venus that is entering your house of behind the scenes and spirituality, and it's a time where and Sun of course follows Venus over here on the 21st, and you will find that you're not really feeling very affectionate. You don't want to, not just not emotionally, but physically, you really won't want to exhibit. You know, you just want to be in a space where you want to. And this is a time, you know, really, Leo's, when you're really getting ready for your birthday. And this phase normally comes to us before we get into a space which is all about ourselves. What is it that I want for myself? Before I get there, I need to be doing homework at the back, at behind the scenes, at the soul level. What is it that is a calling, for me? What is it that really moves me? How it is that I perceive my higher self? And also a lot of research work on that. You know, so this is a time where you're going to be sitting and researching a lot. There's a time where you could be, you could be happy spending a lot of time on your own as well. However, it's a time where you could also be feeling quite secretive. You're not really in a place where you want to share your plans right now. You're not ready because you're still researching and you're reviewing things. However, Leo's, keep in mind that stay transparent and honest in all your dealings, especially emotional ones, because it's also a house when secrets really come out on their own. So it could be a little awkward if you've been trying to suppress something and you don't want to talk about it and you want to tell the other person, and inadvertently that thing just sort of comes out, you know. So if you are in such a situation or such a space, just simplify it, just be honest. Around the 20th, we have a full moon that is there in your house of relationships, creativity, children and romance, but it is squaring Saturn over here as well. And it's a time wherein that, again, a creative project, because a full moon is there. Full moon is, besides being really emotional, it's all about closure, it's about fruition. And this is a time that you'll feel that something is coming to an end, a project is being finished, and also it could be a love affair as well. And it could be that a love affair finally, it's you're seeing the end of that love affair, and But it won't be something that's happening suddenly, Leos. It could be pretty much be in the pipeline. You could have seen it coming, and or it could also be that it has been on and off and on and off for a while. But this is the time where really you break away for good. And try not to sort of try not to get into a quick rebound with this, because it's likely with this kind of a placement, you know, that you may sort of the rebound will not last, because it will be a rebound, but this pattern could get repeated again for you. So try and sort of stay away from you from it. Getting out and having fun is going to be focused for a lot of you. So there is going to be you are going to be feeling really inclined to get out and have fun and take care of yourself, and lesser of this getting the work done. Now the main focus is this month is the squaring of planets that's happening between Jupiter, that is opposing which is in opposition to Neptune, which is further squaring to Saturn. And for you, Jupiter is there in your house of earned income. So I think I would rather focus on the Jupiter bit of it, because it's galvanizing things for you. It's just giving you a sense of increased self-worth, and also an ability to earn more money. So you would find that, you know, you have been earning some good money, and there have been more opportunities for you to earn money as well. And it's a time where you could be looking at your value system very closely as well. And it's a time where you're not really up for doing something really drastic or radical that will just sort of shake your roots. But because this is opposing Neptune, which is there in your house of intimacy and shared resources, it could also be saying, you know, that maybe you need to be looking at your finances. Maybe you need to be looking at your intimacy issues more carefully. And because we have self-esteem, which is there, which is Venus is there. So it's suggesting that it could be a love relationship as well, in which maybe, you know, the issues could have been to do with how it is that you share yourself, or how much of it is that you share yourself in the relationships. Are you just sort of happy to share yourself till a point, and then you don't want to really go beyond it? So this is of that. And it is further, of course, squaring to Neptune is frowning at Saturn, which is there in your house of home. So, and Saturn, because it has been there in your house of home, that's a house of your mother, and that's a house of Cancer as well. And Saturn, of course, likes effort. So there could be that there has been for a year and a half now, because this aspect is there for another year for you till about end of 2017, with Saturn being there in this house of your home, that you could find something or the other is happening. Either there's illnesses that are there, or there are, you know, you're either having to take care of your parents, or there is something that is maybe with the extended family that's happening, or you're having to take care of you know, maybe you have your parents to come and live with you, and there has been this, and through it there have been lessons that you are learning as well. Maybe there is, you are realizing that how much of you is really required right now to be investing your time and your emotions into it. So a lot of, like I said, there is this tug of planets that is there, and everybody is sort of stretching and not refusing to move. But I will still put focus on Jupiter and say, you know, that I think because there is a lot of expansiveness that is there as far as the self-esteem is there. So I think this should sort of help you tide over these things and be able to cope with them gently. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Leos. A quick reminder for those of you who are seeking clarity in your personal lives. For a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Do remember to like, subscribe, and share the videos. I will greatly appreciate that. I'll see you again next month, and thank you so much for watching.